Okay, welcome back students once again. Today we will see our next topic and subject programming in C++, subject of semester 3, computer engineering department of diploma engineering. Okay, so for in this today's lecture, our lecture outcome is initialize data using variables and develop simple C++ program. So after completing this lecture, you are able to use the variables and constants as well in your C++ program, and you can able to prepare a simple program in C++ using variables and constants. Okay, so topic covers to achieve this lecture outcome. That is, first one we discuss about defining constant. Second one is declaration of variable and dynamic initialization of variable, and the third one is reference variable. So start from defining constant. So first of all, what is constant? So constants are nothing but whose values are fixed or neither alter or change throughout the program or throughout the execution of the program. Constants are also referred as literals. Then they are divided into different categories. They are as type of data types. They can be of different types, you can say integer constants, floating point constant, character constant, string constant, boolean value constants, and many more. Okay, so now next, how we can define the constant in C++. So there are two different ways for defining constant in C++. First of all, we can define it using hash define preprocessor, and second method is to using const keyword. So we will start from define preprocessor method. Okay, so for defining constant using this method, we have to use syntax like hash, then define is the keyword, and then identifier value or identifier and then its value. Identifier is your constant name, and value you want to initialize that neither be changed throughout the execution of the program. So in the right side, the example is also given that hash define length is the name of your constant, and 10 is the value initialized to that variable length that might not be changed throughout the execution of your program. Okay, so this is the first method. Now we see our second method of defining constant using const keyword. Okay, so using const keyword, you have to simply write const in front of your variable declaration. So you have to write const and your data type of the variable, and then variable name equal to the value which you are assigning to that variable. So in the right side, same example is given. Const is a keyword, integer is the data type of your length variable, and 10 is the value assigned to that length variable. So throughout the execution of the program, the variable named length, its value will not change. So in this way, we can define constant in two ways. Now our next topic is declaration of variable and dynamic initialization of variable. Okay, so first of all, what is variables? So variables are nothing but the name of the memory location. Okay, these are the basic unit for storing our values in the program. So the values changed during the execution of program. They are nothing but the opposite part of the constant. So variable, for defining the variable, the syntax as data type you have to write, and name of variable equal to, you can also initialize the value at the time of declaration also, or you can assign value after later also in the next execution or in the further lines of the program. So here the example is given, integer length equal to 10. So the length variable has value assigned 10, and it can be changed as per the requirement of the program. Okay, now we go through the dynamic initialization of the variable. So what is dynamic initialization of variable? So dynamic initialization of variable is nothing but you are assigning value to a variable at the runtime of the program. Means you are fetching or giving value to the variable at the runtime, or you can give value from other variables by addition, subtraction, multiplication, any process. Means the main concept is to assigning value at the runtime, not at the declaration time. So that is nothing but the dynamic initialization of your variable. Now we go through one example. that how we are initializing values to a variable dynamically. Okay, so in here one example is given. The void main is your main function, then integer a is one of the variable. So you are printing message to the user that enter value of a. So user will enter value, see in and see out, both function are there. So see in function will fetch the value and store it in a, and enter value will print the message. See out will use to print the message on the screen. Then cube, your cube variable will get the values dynamically from the a, that is a into a into a. So the value user for a user entered, for example, value 10, so 10 into 10 into 10, so the value of cube is 1000, and that will be displayed. So here the cube variable value is dynamically initialized at the runtime or the execution of the program. So this is the example of dynamic initialization value to a variable. Okay, our next topic is reference variable. Reference variable is nothing but an alias name or another name given to already declared variables. So you can access that variable from both the name. It is nothing but if you are storing a value in a variable, then the both variable are pointing to the same memory location. So if you change the value of variable using first name or second name, it will affect the same memory location. So a reference variable is nothing but assigning or different name or alias name to the same memory location or same location, storage location. Okay, now we will see one example. For example, suppose integer I equal to 17. So you are assigning 17 value to I, and your declaration for the reference variable I is as follows. If we want to make R as a reference variable to I, then we have to write like this: integer, then ampersand sign, then R equal to I, means 17 value will assign to R also, and they are R and I both pointing to the same location. So if you are changing the value of R, it will automatically affect the value of I, and if you are changing the value of I, it will automatically affect R, that is vice versa, because they are both pointing to the same location. So this is nothing but the concept of reference variable. Okay, so throughout in this lecture, let's summarize all the topics which we had discussed. First, we had the scene of defining constants, how to define constants. So there are two ways for defining constant, that is, first is the hash define preprocessor method, and second using const keyword. Then we see declaration of variable, how we declare variables in C++. Then we see dynamic initialization of variable, of assigning value to a variable at the runtime. And last, that is reference variable. So that is nothing but the concept of giving an alias name to a variable in which the same memory location has two different names, but they are pointing to the same location. So I hope after completing this lecture, we have achieved our lecture outcome of defining variables and constants, and you can easily able to develop the basic simple C++ programming in it. Okay, thank you for watching this lecture. Thank you.